What's happening in our world? What can we do about it?
Yeah, how do we stay on track when the monkey mind wants to take us in so many different directions? We got through at least three steps. I would say we could say step four would be to, this is a step that will allow you to wake up knowing the two most important things for the day. Wouldn't that be wonderful? If we don't have that, we wake up and who knows what's going to happen. We're probably going to check email and we'll have our agenda hijacked. That's what happens when we check email and voice messages. So wouldn't it be wonderful to just wake up going, I know it, like Neo in the Matrix. I know Kung Fu. Well, it could be like, I know the two biggest things to work on today and I'm going to start on those. So how we do that, set an alarm for say 5 o'clock every day. And the alarm will go off and say, choose your two needle movers. And by that, what's going to move the needle in your life and business. And here's a question that'll focus the mind super well. If I only was allowed to do two things tomorrow, if that was all I did, two things, what would they be? What would I choose? That will focus the mind. You can pop those on a couple of post-it notes and then leave those on your desk or up on the wall or on the computer before you finish work. Then you finish work, you can let your mind go. You can relax. You can be with the family. You do whatever you want because you know what you're going to be working on tomorrow. And then equally important, when you wake up, I prefer and I highly recommend you don't check email. You don't check messages. It's great if you actually have some sprints booked for the morning and 2 hour blocks of time, because I can't expect anyone to stay focused 24/7. That's ridiculous. You have to tell your mind when it's time to be disciplined and when it's time that you can do whatever you want. So I prefer, and we could call this step five, book sprints in your calendar. Could be 9 to 11, 4 days a week. Could be 4 to 6 on a Saturday. Doesn't matter to me. You pick what works for you and have the pause the recording, go and book those sprints and then have those as recurring dates with yourself so that you will actually have time to work on the stuff that really matters. Without those sprints, it's you're getting pulled in different directions. And then when you have those sprints, let's say you wake up in the morning, you do your ritual. It could be a little bit of dancing. You might do some yoga. Some people grab their green smoothie or their cup of tea or take a little walk, whatever it is. You do your ritual, but then start on those two things and you're going to feel so good at the end of the day. Let's jump forward 2 weeks from now and you've been doing this for 2 weeks. I just want you to send me an email, send Shai and Craig an email about how good it feels to know that you're actually being deliberate about achieving your goals and you're not chasing every single monkey treat.